Good evening, and we welcome you to St. Joseph's Episcopal Church with open arms and open hearts. Please be reverent while we worship, and we encourage you to fully participate in our service with responses and song. Thank you.
What wondrous love is this, oh my soul, what wondrous love is this, oh my soul, what wondrous love is this that caused the Lord of bliss to bear dreadful curse for my soul, to bear the dreadful curse for my soul. When I was sinking down, sinking down beneath God's righteous frown, Christ laid aside his crown for my soul, Christ laid aside his crown for my soul. To God and to the death I'm free, I'll sing on, and when from death I'm free, I'll sing on, and when from death I'm free, I'll sing and joyful be, and through eternity,
good evening and welcome to evening prayer. Our preacher for this morning, for this evening, is Paula St. Clair, and Wendy Rowley is the voice of the people.
Some others to win. the Savior to help you, comfort, strengthen, and keep you. He is willing to aid you. He will carry you through. Shun evil companions, bad language, disdain. God's name hold in reverence, nor take it in vain. Be thoughtful and earnest, high-hearted and true. Look ever to Jesus. He will carry you through. You just ask the Savior to help you, comfort, strengthen, and keep you. He is willing to aid you. He will carry the Savior to help you, comfort, strengthen, and keep you. He is willing to aid you. He will carry you through. You just ask the Savior to help you, comfort, strengthen, and keep you.
All we, like sheep, have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. O God, the Father, creator of heaven and earth,
have mercy upon us.
O God, the Son, redeemer of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O God, the Holy Ghost, sanctifier of the faithful,
have mercy upon us.
O Holy, Blessed, and Glorious Trinity, one God,
have mercy upon us.
Remember not, Lord Christ, our offenses, nor the offenses of our forefathers, neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, good Lord. Spare thy people whom thou hast redeemed with thy most precious blood, and by thy mercy preserve us forever.
Spare us, good Lord,
from all evil and wickedness. from sin, from the crafts and assaults of the devil, and from everlasting damnation.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From all blindness of heart, from pride, vainglory, and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, and malice, and from all want of charity.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From all inordinate and sinful affections, and from all the deceits of the world, the flesh, and the devil.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart and contempt of thy word and commandment.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire, and flood, from plague, pestilence, and famine.
Good Lord, deliver us.
From all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion, from violence, battle, and murder, and from dying suddenly and unprepared.
Good Lord, deliver us.
By thy mystery of the holy incarnation, by thy holy nativity and submission of the law, by thy baptism, fasting, and temptation.
Good Lord, deliver us.
By thy agony and bloody sweat, by thy cross and passion, by thy precious death and burial, by thy glorious resurrection and ascension, and by thy coming of the Holy Ghost.
Good Lord, deliver us.
In all time of our tribulation, in all time of our prosperity, in the hour of death and in the day of judgment.
Good Lord, deliver us.
We sinners do beseech thee to hear us, O Lord God, and that it may please thee to rule and govern thy holy church.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to illumine all bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding of thy word, and that both by their preaching and living, they may set it forth and show it accordingly.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to bless and keep all thy people.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to send forth laborers into thy harvest and to draw all mankind into thy holy kingdom.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to give to all people increase of grace, to hear and receive thy word, and to bring forth the fruits of the Spirit.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to bring into the way of truth all such as have erred and are deceived.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to give us a heart to love and fear thee, and diligently to live after thy commandments.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to rule the hearts of thy servants, the President of the United States, and all others in authority, that they may do justice and love mercy and walk in the ways of truth.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to make wars to cease in all the world, to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord, and to bestow freedom upon all peoples.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to show thy pity upon all prisoners and captives, the homeless and the hungry, and all who are desolate and oppressed.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to give and preserve to our use the bountiful fruit of the earth, so that in due time all may enjoy them.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to inspire us in our several callings to do the work which thou givest us to do with singleness of heart as thy servant and for the common good.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to preserve all who are in danger by reason of their labor and their travail.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to preserve and provide for all women in childbirth, young children and orphans, the widowed, and all whose homes are broken or torn by strife.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to visit the lonely, to strengthen all who suffer in mind, body, and spirit, and to comfort with thy presence those who are failing and infirm.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to support, help, and comfort all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to have mercy upon all mankind.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sins, negligence, and ignorance, and to endue us with grace of the Holy Spirit to amend our lives according to thy holy word.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to strengthen us to do stand, to comfort and help the weak-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally to beat down Satan under our feet.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to grant all the faithful departed eternal life and peace.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to grant that in the fellowship of Saint Joseph and all the saints, we may obtain thy heavenly kingdom.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
Son of God, we beseech thee to hear us.
Son of God, we beseech thee to hear us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
grant us thy peace.
O Christ, hear us.
O Christ, hear us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
O Lord, let thy mercy be showed upon us
as we put our trust in thee.
Let us pray. Almighty God, who has promised to hear the petitions of those who ask in thy Son's name, we beseech thee mercifully to incline thine ear to us who have now made our prayers and supplication unto thee, and grant that those things which we have asked faithfully according to thy will may be obtained effectually to the relief of our necessity and to the set forth of thy glory through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Psalm 36, verses 5 to 11. Your love, O Lord, reaches to the heavens, and your faithfulness to the clouds. Your righteousness is like the strong mountains, your justice like the great deep. You save both man and beast, O Lord. How priceless is your love, O God. Your people take refuge under the shadow of your wings. They feast upon the abundance of your house. You give them drink from the river of your delights. For with you is the well of life, and in your light we see light. Continue your loving kindness to those who know you, and your favor to those who are true of heart. Let not the foot of the proud come near me, nor the hand of the wicked push me aside. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
A reading from Isaiah, chapter 42, verses 1 to 9. Here is my servant, whom I uphold, my chosen, in whom my soul delights. I have put my spirit upon him. He will bring forth justice to the nations. He will not cry or lift up his voice or make it heard in the street. A bruised reed he will not break, and a dimly burning wick he will not quench. He will faithfully bring forth justice. He will not grow faint to be crushed until he has established justice in the earth, and the coastlands wait for his teaching. Thus says God, the Lord, who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread out the earth and what comes from it, who gives breath to the people upon it and spirit to those who walk in it. I am the Lord. I have called you in righteousness. I have taken you by the hand and kept you. I have given you as a covenant to the people, a light to the nations, to open the eyes that are blind, to bring out the prisoners from the dungeon, from the prison those who sit in darkness. I am the Lord, that is my name. My glory I give to no other, nor my praise to idols. See, the former things have come to pass, and new things I now declare. Before they spring forth, I tell you of them, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Canticle 3, the Song of Mary. My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior. For he hath regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For behold, from henceforth, all generations shall call me blessed, for that is mighty hath magnified me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on them that fear him throughout all generation. He hath showed strength with his arms. He hath scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He hath put down the mighty from their seat, and hath exalted the humble and meek. He hath filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he hath sent away. He, remembering his mercy, hath holpened his servant Israel, as he promised to our forefathers, Abraham, and his seed forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Miss Pauline, you're muted.
Pauline, if you're still there, you're on mute, but we cannot hear you. I think she's having some technical difficulty. Is there someone willing to read?
I'll read. I can read.
Okay. Go ahead, Justin.
A reading from a letter to the Hebrews, chapter 9, verses 11 to 15. When Christ came as a high priest of the good things that have come, then through the greater and perfect tent, not made with hands, that is not of this creation, he entered once for all into the holy place, not with the blood of goats and calves, but with his own blood, thus obtaining eternal redemption. For if the blood of goats and bulls, with the sprinkling of the ashes of a heifer, sanctifies those who have been defiled so that their flesh is purified, how much more will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without blemish to God, purify our conscience from dead works to worship the living God? For this reason, he is the mediator of a new covenant, so that those who are called may receive the promised eternal inheritance, because a death has occurred that redeems them from the transgressions under the first covenant. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Canticle 17, a song of creation. Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, according to thy word. For my eyes have seen the glory, that seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to enlighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of all thy people Israel. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever, and will be forever be. Amen.
Through the tears that made her blind, she felt such pain. Some spoke in anger, heard folks whisper, there's no place here for her kind. Still on she came, through the shame that flushed her face, till at last she knelt before his feet. And though she spoke no words, everything she said was heard. As she poured her love for the master from her box of alabaster, my praise on him, like oil from Mary's alabaster vase. Don't be angry if I wash his feet with my tears and I dry them with my hair. You weren't there. I can't forget the way was a prisoner to the sin that had me bound. I spent my days, poured my life without measure into a little treasure box I thought I found. Until the day when Jesus came to me and healed my soul with the wonder of his touch. So now I'm giving back to him all the praise he's worthy of. I've been forgiven, and that's why I love him so much. And I've come to pour my praise on him like all. Don't be angry if I wash his feet with my tears and dry them with my hair. My head, you are there. The night Jesus found me, you did not feel what I felt when he wrapped his loving arms around me.
A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John chapter 12 verses 1 to 11. 6 days before the Passover, Jesus came to Bethany, the home of Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. There they gave a dinner for him. Martha served, and Lazarus was one of those at the table with him. Mary took a pound of costly perfume, made of pure nard, anointed Jesus' feet, and wiped them with her hair. The house was filled with fragrance of perfume. But Judas Iscariot, one of the 12, one of his disciples, the one who was about to betray him, said, "Why was this perfume not sold for 300 denarii and the money given to the poor?" He said this not because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief. He kept the common purse and used to steal what was put into it. Jesus said, "Leave her alone. She brought it so that she might keep it for the day of my burial. You will always have the poor with you, but you do not always have me." When the great crowd of the Jews learned that he was there, they came not only because of Jesus, but also to see Lazarus, whom he had raised from the dead. So the chief priests planned to put Lazarus to death as well, since it was on account of him that many of the Jews were deserting and were believing in Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Good evening, everyone. For those who may be on and don't know who I am, my name is Paula Kong Sinclair, and it's a privilege to be able to share this word with you on Monday of Holy Week. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Here we are in Holy Week after yesterday's recall of Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem. At the end of a busy day, we see Jesus tired and returns to Bethany. And Bethany is a village close to the capital where Jesus would stay when he was in Jerusalem. In the last days of his early life, Jesus spent long hours devoting himself to an intense schedule of preaching and teaching in Jerusalem. And it is here, usually they say, on Holy Mondays when Jesus went into the temple and overturned the money changers' tables. When night came, Jesus would recover his strength in the house of his friends. And we know his friends were Mary and Martha and his good buddy Lazarus. And it is in Bethany that we read that the scene of today's gospel takes place. It says 6 days before Passover, St. John relates, Jesus went to Bethany. They had dinner there. Martha served, and Lazarus was one of those reclining at the table with him. Mary took a pound of ointment. This was genuine nard of great value, and she anointed the feet of Jesus, and then she wiped his feet with her hair. And the house was filled with the fragrance of the ointment. As I read this story, I think about the generosity of this woman, Mary. I think she wants to show her gratitude to her master for having brought her brother back to life, as we remember that story, and for so many other benefits she had received from him. There was no way to repay them. And here we also see Judas, who is present at the dinner. And here Judas is calculating exactly the price of the ointment. Mary's action, we see, was an extravagant act of worship that showed her wholehearted devotion to Jesus. Mary knew Jesus well and was inspired to honor him. She was glad to sacrifice something valuable in order to express her love for Jesus. We know Jesus was about to make the ultimate sacrifice of dying on the cross for humanity's sins to make salvation possible. Looking ahead to what he planned to do for all the people, Jesus connected Mary's anointing to his work as the world's savior. In biblical times, anointing someone was a sign that God had chosen that person for a particular role. Priests and kings, as we read in the Old Testament, were anointed. And as humanity's high priest and the ultimate king of an eternal kingdom, Jesus' anointing points to his role as God's chosen savior of the world. Mary's anointing again points to Christ's identity as Messiah king. But it also points to his humble position as servant king. When Mary anoints Jesus's feet and then wipes them with her hair, she foreshadows Jesus's actions at the upcoming Last Supper, when the Lord washes the disciples' feet and teaches them how to love one another through sacrificial, humble service. I think there are three important spiritual lessons we can learn from the story of Mary anointing Jesus's feet. The first one is that God is worthy of our worship. All of us worship someone or something in our lives according to how we decide to spend our time and energy. Whatever we devote our attention to the most from day to day is essentially what we're worshiping. This story of Mary's act of worship shows us that there is no one and nothing more deserving of our worship than God. Should we therefore try to get rid of any idols in our lives? Whoever or whatever we're giving more attention to than we're giving God, and make God our top priority in our schedules and in our decisions. The more we choose to worship God, the more we will recognize his wonder and feel his awe. The second spiritual lesson I think we can learn from this story is that God doesn't hold anything back from us. God loves us completely and unconditionally. This story of Jesus' anointing foreshadows how Jesus gave his all on the cross for us. He made the ultimate sacrifice so we can enjoy eternal relationships with God. As John 3:16 tells us, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life." My friends, there are no limits to what God is willing to do for us because of his great love for us. God not only has love for us, but God actually is love at its core. As 1 John 4:16 declares, "And so we know and rely on the love of God, the love God has for us. God is love. Whoever lives in God, in love, lives in God and God in them." The third spiritual lesson I think we could learn is that we shouldn't hold back anything from God. In our relationships with God, we shouldn't hold back our love from God. God is worthy of all our love, and he doesn't hold back his love for us. So like Mary in this story, we should give our wholehearted devotion to God. Jesus reveals to us in Matthew 22:37, the greatest commandment, the Shema, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. Love is more than an emotion, it's an action. We often have opportunities to show our love for God through our work. And Colossians 3, 23-24 encourages us, whatever you do, work at it with all your heart as working for the Lord, not for human masters, since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward. It is the Lord Christ you are serving. Just like Mary did, let's give our very best to God. We can apply the wisdom from these lessons by doing our best to pour out our lives as an offering to God, just like Mary poured out valuable perfume to show God her love. Our attention shows what we value most. Mary's attention to Jesus reveals that she highly valued him. Are we giving our attention first and foremost to our relationships with God? How often do we think of God? How often do we communicate with him? Are we reading the Bible, God's love letter to us regularly? Have we built prayer and meditation habits we enjoy? How often are we thanking God for his love and the blessings he's giving us? Are we seeking God's wonder and celebrating it? Are we approaching worship as more than just a weekly service, but as a constant lifestyle? What are we doing to show God from day to day that we truly, truly adore him? Our time is like Mary's perfume, a highly valuable resource that we should use well. In order to do so, we should make our relationship with God our top priority. Do our schedules show that we're centering our lives on our relationship with God? Every day we can ask the Holy Spirit to help us worship God wholeheartedly without holding anything back. We can base our decisions on the Holy Spirit's guidance and then enjoy how doing so welcomes God's love into our lives. Finally, my friends, the Bible story in which Mary anoints Jesus' feet with perfume powerfully shows love in action. Mary recognized God's true value and responded to a loving God with loving worship. By looking at Mary's example of devotion to Jesus, we can find the inspiration we need to fully receive and give love in our relationship with God. May our Lord help us all to love him with the same type of unbridled love as Mary loved him. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us say together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful,
we entreat thee, O Lord.
That thy holy angels may lead us in the path of peace and goodwill,
we entreat thee, O Lord.
That there may be peace to thy church and the whole world,
we entreat thee, O Lord.
That we may depart this life in thy faith and fear and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ,
we entreat thee, O Lord.
That we may be bound together by thy Holy Spirit in communion of Saint Joseph's and all thy saints, entrusting one another and all our life to Christ,
we entreat thee, O Lord.
Lord Jesus, stay with us, for evening is at hand and the day is past. Be our companion in the way. Kindle our hearts and awaken hope, that we may know thee as thou art revealed in Scripture and the breaking of the bread. Grant this for the sake of thy love.
Amen.
Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night, and give thine angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ, give rest to the weary, bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for thy love's sake.
Amen.
Almighty God, whose most dear Son went not up to joy, but first he suffered pain and entered not into glory before he was crucified, mercifully grant that we, walking in the way of the cross, may find it none other than the way of life and peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
And Almighty God, who has given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication unto thee, and hast promised through thy well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, thou wilt be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come, life everlasting.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore.
Amen.
And Almighty God, we pray you graciously to behold this your family, for whom our Lord Christ, Jesus Christ, was willing to be betrayed and given into the hands of sinners and to suffer death upon the cross, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Surrender all to him.
Amen. I'd like to say thank you to the readers, and especially thank you to our homilist, Ms. Paula Kahn, for a wonderful sermon and starting us off this Holy Week with a wonderful sermon and things to ponder. We continue this week, tomorrow, with Holy Tuesday, where we'll have a 7 p.m. virtual service on Zoom, which is Tenebrae. And then we will start again. We'll have our Wednesday service at 10:30 a.m. as usual, followed at 7 p.m. for our healing service in person at St. Thomas. Monday, Thursday, we will celebrate with St. Thomas the service, and then afterwards, we will have our traditional agape meal for those members of St. Joseph's. On Good Friday, we will start at noon in person at St. Thomas, and Holy Saturday, we will start at 6 p.m. at St. Thomas. All the in-person services will be videoed, and you may watch it live streaming on our YouTube page, St. Joseph's Episcopal Church, Queens Village. I pray that you will have a wonderful rest of the night and look forward to seeing you all tomorrow. Thank you.
Night.
Night.